just going to have a look at constructive criticism on each of them, because it's very difficult to stand up here and, you know, in front of all you guys, hard crowd, please, you're all mad Wicked fans. So our first guy, Josh, isn't it? Yes, Josh. We thought it was a fantastic, great choice of song. I thought that you really thought about what you were doing and singing. I could see your acting through your song. It was beautifully done. You know, I could actually see you in a couple of years' time auditioning for the role. So that really, but I'll pass.
I think your trousers are really nice. The difficult thing is when you're doing it out of context, when you're in the show, you've got people to play opposite and whatever. Here, it's a concert style performance, and you really, really did get this crowd going. You were the first person out. It was a hard task to undertake, and I was really, really impressed. Gave you a standing ovation because I thought you thoroughly deserved it. Well done. Good job.
Yeah, I thought you absolutely were the crowd. They were loving you. Like, you had so much fun, and you directed it at people, and you got the crowd, you know, joining in on the jazz ballroom, and, you know, it's brilliant. So I thought, you know, you were really great, and again, like Rachel, I can totally see you auditioning for it in a few years. Yeah.
Well done. And Sarah, absolutely brilliant. Talk about dedication. That was absolutely brilliant. And the only girl, well done. Again, you know, that's obviously you wouldn't turn up for an audition greenified because they would just think you're a bit strange. But you wouldn't do that. But I loved the effort. It was really fantastic. I know it was a bit hard probably hearing yourself up here, and you couldn't really hear, could you? Probably if you'd have stood this side of the speakers. But no, don't worry. Listen, you've done a fantastic job. Again, thought about all your lyrics, and, you know, it's just as important that we believe what you're singing and that we believe you're acting through your song. That's, you know, if you can hit the notes, it's great, obviously, you know, but you've got to think about the words you're singing, and I thought you'd done it brilliantly.
We were commenting also that within Wicked, The Wizard and I is one of the most incredible songs, but it's really long when it's actually away from the show, isn't it? And you helped with that really, really long intro where Madame Horrible usually sings, but we should have got Julie up to do it with you.
Yeah.
You just stayed completely in character and you didn't let it throw you at all. And I know that you guys have not had much time to familiarise yourself with the backing tracks, so that was seriously impressive. And I love that you brought your own props. Good girl.
I said to Rachel, is that a Gucci? Looks Gucci. That's lovely. I thought that you acted through the song so well. You know, you really went on a journey. And I even said to Rachel as well, I didn't believe, like, it was such an epic song. Like, it goes on for so long, and to obviously keep the audience kind of with you through that journey. I mean, you did that beautifully. So, brilliant. Really well done.
Absolutely blew the crowd away, Ben. That was really... Your vocals are incredible. Like, not an obvious choice of song and Divine Gravity for the male to sing it, but there are a lot of males out there, I'm sure, with their hairbrushes and combs in the mirror, giving it a punch. I mean, you know, you've held the flag. That's really... Your vocals are incredible, and you know, we were pretty speechless down there, so thank you, really, Jamie, really. And again, you stayed in character. I could see your passion. You really meant what you were singing. I could almost feel that burning in your stomach that you're meant to feel, for us to feel it, and I almost cried, so really well done.
That's a nice compliment. Rachel Tucker, Elphaba from the West End cast of Wicked, almost cried at your performance. I don't think I really need to say anything else. That was heartburn. congratulations. I'd just like to say, not that I'm being like biased or anything, but to see two guys up here, as a male performer, who I was the only boy in my dance school for 7 years when I was growing up, and I had to really stick at it, and to see two of you is an inspiration to me, so well done. Keep going. And to come here and belt your boobies off to Defying Gravity is absolutely, it's so impressive, and well done. You stayed in character the whole time, and you made it your own.
Yeah.
You know, you kind of, I think Rachel probably wanted to steal a few of those little riffs and stuff, but well done.
Yeah, Ben, I just loved your attitude. Like, you stepped out of it and there was real attitude, wasn't there? Like, you really went for it. And it was almost like when you stepped out, you could hear. I thought his light and shade was really good. And then had his big moments, and that's really important in a song as well because it gives it nice variation. And but you were absolutely fantastic, and obviously for a guy to sing that song was just amazing. So yeah, so good, amazing.
Who's going to win this really impressive prize?
Actually, can we just say the prizes? It's an amazing Wicked family experience. You get to stay with your family in a hotel in London, come to see the show, meet the cast. So it's quite a special prize. Guys, we found this really, really difficult. I don't know if it sounds so cliche, but we did. All so fantastic, and I can see your all heart and souls were in this, but we thought it had to come down to it brought to you guys as an audience the most believable, the most out there, thought about character-wise choice, and we have to say the winner today, the Wicked Karaoke in Family Experience, is Josh.
Photo call. So, guys, do you want them closer or further away? Closer?